Hey friends, I'll bet you know that WordPress is the most popular content management system, powering over 43% of the websites on the internet. But I bet you didn't know that WordPress is not only available on Azure App Service, but we're adding over 3,500 new WordPress sites on Azure each month. Chalika Chowdhury is here to show me how easy it is to get started today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Chalika Chowdhury. How are you?
I'm doing good. How are you, Scott?
I am very excited. I had no idea there was so much WordPress on Azure. That is fantastic. I love Azure App Service.
And I love WordPress. It is so easy to design and create your sites on WordPress. In fact, I'll show you my site in a little bit, which I put up in the last 30 minutes. But let's go ahead and start on how you can create a WordPress site. We start with the marketplace. So you can go to marketplace and search for WordPress on App Service, which will bring you right to our offering. And just hit the create button, which takes you right to the create screen. We've tried to make it as easy as possible for you to create a WordPress site. I'm just going to change the location to be something else. Okay. And you can change your hosting plan. The hosting plan determines what kind of SKU you're going to use for your app service, so you can change it. And we have SKUs which is available for all kinds of users. A basic SKU for the hobbyist, a standard SKU for general purpose, and a premium SKU if you have a really heavy workload. Notice that, you know, that's all you need to do. You need to give a name for your site, and you need to give a username password, which is for the admin persona. So WordPress has two personas. One is the main site persona, which your blog that everybody's going to browse to, and your admin panel where who is going to put all the content in. So you can give your username password over there, and you can hit the create button right here and you're done. But sometimes you might want a little more configuration. And one of the things that you could do is hit the advanced button over here. And you will see that these are some of the things that we recommend. We do it by default for you, so you don't have to worry about it. But in case you want to go ahead and check and change some settings. So we automatically configure Azure CDN for you. This automatically creates a profile and an endpoint for you so that all static content is cached on our CDN servers. In case you don't want to use CDN, but want to take advantage of Azure Front Door, which is the Microsoft Modern CDN, in that case, you can uncheck this box and enable Front Door. And this will now work as a reverse proxy, where there are 118 locations on which your content will start getting cached, and those are the locations we'll serve the content from. There's also a blob storage integration. So by default, App Service does provide you with storage, but sometimes you want something which is a little faster. And over here, we'll allow you to enable blob storage, especially if you've got a website which's got a lot of media and content, then you know you might want to use your own blob storage account. And finally, you have the virtual network. The virtual network, again, you don't need to worry about it. This is a network because we are creating multiple resources, like your VM, which is going to host your site, your database. We want them all to reside on the same network. So that's why we automatically create a virtual network. But you can use an existing network if you have one. So once you've got the settings, just hit review and create, and this will start creating your WordPress site.
You know what I like about this is that, you know, I've created a million app service sites myself, but what you've done here is you've really created a create screen that is custom to WordPress that is the best practices. It really, you know, is the perfect example of best practices, because I could go and make an app service myself. I could try to deploy WordPress, but I'm going to say, oh, you know, I forgot I need a CDN. And, you know, do I need MySQL? Do I need MySQL Flexi Server? And you've brought all of the best practices into one single, you know, pane of glass, one page.
Yep. And that's so easy. Oh, that makes WordPress so easy to configure on App Service.
Yeah, that's so great. I love having best practices set up for me.
So we can create the review and create, and that's going to create your site. I'm not going to do this right now because it takes about 15 minutes to create the site. Because under the hoods, what we are doing is we are provisioning the site for you. We're downloading the WordPress image, adding all the customizations that you see over there. So it takes about 10 to 15 minutes for the site to provision. So instead of that, last night, while I was thinking about the presentation, I thought I'll set up my own WordPress site. And I took about 30 minutes. So recently, during the last 2 years, I've acquired a new hobby, which is painting. So I decided that I'm going to create my own portfolio. So this is my WordPress site. It is just an app service. So which you can see right from here, the name is the app name, .ashowebsites.net, which tells you that it is just an app service. And the cool thing about WordPress is it's got so many themes and plugins that you don't have to, even if you're not a designer, you don't have to really think a whole lot while you're trying to design your site. So this is my website, and these are some of the paintings I've done. I thought this was a good opportunity to showcase my paintings in case anybody's looking to give me some commissions.
Let me ask you this, though. So you've easily and quickly created your own website, whether it be for your paintings or your, you know, your hobbies or whatever you're interested in, maybe a small business. But how do you know that it's going to be kept up to date, have the right version of PHP, the right version of Linux? You want to focus on painting and your hobbies. You don't want to focus on making your site secure and safe and scalable.
Exactly. And so under the hoods, App Service is a fully managed platform, which means that we take care of maintaining the PHP version, the MySQL version, and also the Linux versions on which the site is running. We automatically will do the updates for you and manage everything for you. So in fact, I can go to the dashboard right now, and you can, since I'm on the admin persona, I can go to the dashboard for my site just right here. And you can see that we are running WordPress 6.2, which is the latest version of WordPress. We are running PHP 8.1, which is one less than the latest version. We are going to go to 8.2 in the next couple of weeks. So you can see that, and we automatically maintain this for you. The things that we don't automatically update for you are like plugins and themes. So you can have your own. We install some themes and plugins for you, but we don't automatically update it for you. And the reason for that is we don't know if we update the theme, that might break certain things on your site. So we encourage you to go and update your themes and plugins on yourself rather than we automatically doing it for you.
Right. That makes sense. But I understand that you do install plugins and configure them for performance because things like W3 Total Cache is a really popular and common plugin. But honestly, I wouldn't know how to install it and set it up for Azure CDN. Yes. You actually do that for me.
Exactly. So you can go over here and look at your installed plugins. And you can see that we installed 3 plugins for you. One is the anti-spam plugin, just to make sure that, you know, you don't get malicious attacks. Mm-hmm. And the 2 other plugins, which we specifically install for performance reasons, is Smush, which minifies your images and improves performance and improves SEO with your site. And we also do W3 Total Cache. Now, remember how in the create experience, we were adding a CDN? What it really does is the endpoint of the CDN is configured into Total Cache. So which means that every time now you request a page, it goes to the cache page and tries to get it from the cache. I can show how it looks from the settings itself. And if you go to the settings, you can see that it has automatically set up the CDN for you. And the CDN is Microsoft Azure Storage. Remember that small checkbox over there where I said enable storage? It created a storage account for you. And in the storage account, you can go and look at this storage account too. So you can see this is your account name. It has set up your account key, your container, SSL support. And this is your storage URL, the endpoint URL, which is automatically set. So by default, we cache all our content for 7 days unless, of course, you've changed the cache control header and made it private. In that case, obviously, we don't do the caching. But otherwise, your content is cached for 7 days. You can purge your caches from here. You can, you know, use the caches. You can change the time on how long you want the cache to be available, and so on, which allows you to completely manage your cache and improve performance for your site.
You know what's nice about this is you've set this up to be powerful with a lot of settings and options for the professional, for the Azure familiar. But for regular folks, they want a WordPress site. They want to think about these things. They can use the default template, the default settings, and they can spend their time customizing their plugins and their themes. And they really don't have to worry about the day-to-day running because, as you said before, App Service is a managed platform.
Exactly. So we take all the management overload from you and you just concentrate on stuff you do well, which is designing your website, setting up your e-commerce site, or whatever you want to use WordPress for.
But if I had if I had an existing WordPress site on another platform, would it be hard to get over to Azure?
WordPress by default provides a plugin which allows you to do migration. So there are two ways of doing a migration. One is that you can do a manual migration. And the second is WordPress provides a plugin that you can install. So you can create a WordPress site, install the plugin, and then specify where you want to migrate from. And if it's an on-premise site, it'll do it from the on-premise site. But I also want to mention that we are working on a migration tool which will make this much more easier for you. So you can provide a source and a destination and we'll automatically do the migration. So hopefully in the next 2-3 months, we're going to release a new tool which does the whole migration for you.
Very cool, very exciting.
Since this is an app service, another thing that you can do, you can manage it just like an app service. So you can go to your app. So this is my app that I was showing you earlier. Mm-hmm. And you can go to your app and you can manage everything for your app. Some of the things that you might want to do is you might want to scale up or scale out your app service plan. So let's say that you start getting a lot of traffic for your WordPress site and my portfolio becomes extremely popular. In that case, you can go ahead and add more instances, which is what the goodness app services provides by default. So you can say, I can do scale, either manual or rule-based, and you can set up how many instances you want for your site. You can do automatic rule-based scaling. So you can say, if I get more than 1,000 requests, let me scale out. You can even scale up. So you can say, oh, I'm running on standards queue, but that's no longer important for me. I want to run on premium, and you can scale up as well. So everything which is available for app service will work for you. Another option that we have is sometimes when you do the create over there, we as I said, we go behind the scenes and we'll do a lot of configuration for you, but you might later decide, oh, this is not what I wanted and I want to change my configuration. So you can just go to your configuration tab, which is just a bunch of environment variables that we automatically set for you. And you can go ahead and change the environment variables to reflect the new settings. So see how we had configured our blob container. So it automatically created, it said that your blob storage is enabled. It gave you a container name. So later on, if you want to change it to something else, you have a different blob storage, you can do that. CDN is enabled by default, and it gives you the CDN endpoint. Again, that's something that you can change. Another thing which a lot of our customers have been asking for and they sometimes want to change is change the database host and database name. So by default, we've set up a database for you, created the tables for you, but you might later on have a different database you want to connect to. So all you need to do is you need to come over here, change your database host and your name, and of course your username password, and that will automatically reconfigure your database to be using whatever you want to use. This is over here, your admin username and password. So in case you want to go ahead and check what is your username password, in case you've forgotten what you set at the time of creation, you can do that. You can rename it to whatever you want to.
Where can I learn more about getting started? Where do I send my family and friends to get them up to speed on WordPress on App Service?
So we can, so this is the quick start that we have available for WordPress. And this will tell you exactly how to get started, what versions of PHP we are running, what versions of MySQL we are running, how can you change your different MySQL versions. We also have this website which lists all the various application settings that we have for WordPress. So in case you want to manually play around with things, you have a WordPress site which is reading a lot of content. By default, we say that the startup time is 900, but you might want to change it to something longer. You can do local cache. So I just wanted to mention the local storage cache. The local storage cache is interesting because by default for App Service, we store everything in a storage account. But for performance reasons, it would be good to have the content locally on the VM. And if you have the setting enabled, in that case, your content is now served from the VM itself. So you can get much faster speed than you would get if you were doing the content from a storage account. We also have things like the memory limit, so you can set up the memory limits for your WordPress site. This would be useful in case, because our VMs have fixed memory, so which means that if you're going to run more than one WordPress site on a VM, you might want to change the memory limits to see how much each site will take. So you can go through these. A lot of these are self-explanatory, but you can go to these settings, which is how you can customize your WordPress site.
Very cool. I like that you have made it really easy to get started, really easy for the basics, but you've also got good, better, best, where you can pick your performance. And then for those that like to tweak or those that are familiar with both WordPress and App Service, I've got lots of options on how to make that happen. This is a really exciting opportunity, and I can now see why there are thousands of new WordPress sites on Azure App Service every month. Well, thank you so much for showing me this today.
Thank you, Scott, for having me. This was fun.
I appreciate learning all about WordPress on Azure App Service today on Azure Friday. Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it, watch more Azure Friday.